So semiconductor physics is the unit 5 of our applied physics course. The contents of the semiconductor physics are origin of energy bands in crystalline solids, classification of solids based on energy bands, chemical bonds in semiconductors, intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors, Fermi energy level, intrinsic carrier concentration, p-type and n-type semiconductor and their carrier concentrations, equation for conductivity, drift, diffusion and Einstein's equation, finally Hall effect and its applications. Learning outcomes. After the completion of this unit, students will be able to understand. They will classify the energy bands of semiconductors. They will outline the properties of n-type and p-type semiconductors. They can identify the type of semiconductor by using Hall effect. Today's class, we will discuss about origin of energy bands in crystalline solids, classification of solids based on energy bands. Origin of energy bands in crystalline solids. In an isolated atom, there are discrete energy levels as 1s, 2s, 3s, so on, which are occupied by the electrons of the atom. So here I am taking sodium as an example. We know sodium is a metal. It contains 11 electrons and their electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. So the first 10 electrons are completely filled, that is 1s, 2s and 2p. So if all the atoms of a solid are assumed to be isolated from one another, then they have completely identical electronic schemes of their energy levels as shown in above figure. When these isolated atoms are brought together to form a solid, various interactions occur between the neighboring atoms. During this interaction, the higher energy levels are affected considerably, and consequently the energy levels of the outer shells are slightly altered without violating Pauli's exclusion principle. What is Pauli's exclusion principle? No two electrons can have the same four quantum numbers. That is, there may be difference in principal quantum number or orbital quantum number or magnetic quantum number or spin quantum number. If the two electrons have same principal quantum number, orbital quantum number and magnetic quantum number, then there is a difference in spin quantum number. That is the Pauli's exclusion principle, we know very well. Here, in individual atom, the energy levels are singlet energy levels. When we are taking account into a solid which contains a large number of atoms, all the single energy levels of individual atoms are combined to form a band, which is shown in figure B. Hence, the single energy levels of atoms split into large number of energy levels as shown in above figure B. Since there are many atoms in a solid, so the separation between the split energy level is very small. Hence, the split energy levels are almost continuous and are said to form an energy band. It can be explained with an example. If you take a single atom, it contains the two levels as 3s and 2p. Here the energy difference between 3s and 3p is shown by an upward arrow. When we are taking account into 5 atoms in a close proximity, the 5 individual atoms of 3s levels and 5 individual energy levels of 3p levels are shown in the figure. Here the energy difference between the highest field of 3s and the lowest field of 3p is small than compared to the first one, that is single atom. But when we are taking into multitudes of atoms in close proximity, that is we are taking a large number of atoms, so all atoms of individual 3s levels are combined to form a band, and all individual atoms of individual 3p levels are combined to form a 3p band. So there is a small difference between the 3s and 3p, they may be overlap. So this takes place in the solids. This is the condition for origin of energy bands in the solids. There are energy bands in a solid corresponding to the energy levels in an atom, we can show with the help of a sodium. So we know electronic configuration of sodium, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. So this is the lowest level in the above diagram shows 1s2 which is filled, and then 2s2 which is filled, 2p6 and it is completely filled. But the 3s level is not completely filled. Here the 3s level contains only one electron of each individual atom. So all individual atoms of one electrons are combined to form a band, that is completely filled band, not here. Here the band is half filled. So the half filled band, the electrons which are present in that band is called valency band, and the remaining half filled can be called as a conduction band, and the difference between the conduction band and valency band is called forbidden band. An electron in a solid can have only those discrete energies that lie within these energy bands. These energy bands are known as the allowed energy bands, which are generally separated by some energy gap, known as the forbidden energy bands or not allowed energy bands. Energy band occupied by the valency electrons that are called free electrons is known as valency band, and the energy band which is empty or occupied by the conduction electrons is known as conduction band. In the above diagram, the valency band and the conduction band are shown. Here in the above diagram, the conduction band is empty, the valency band is filled with electrons. So we can discuss the classification of crystalline solids. On the basis of the forbidden energy gap, solids are broadly classified into the following three categories: insulators, semiconductors and conductors. First we will discuss about the insulators. Here in insulators, the energy band gap between valency band and conduction band is very large. Solids behaves as insulators if it satisfies the following two conditions. Solids have even number of valency electrons per atom. That means in the valency band or the valence electrons are even. The valency band and the conduction band are separated by a large energy gap compared with KT. Due to the large energy band gap between the conduction band and the valency band, the electron cannot jump from valency band to the conduction band. In insulators, the valence electrons are bound tightly to their parent atoms. In case of glass, the valency band is completely filled at 0 Kelvin, and the energy gap between the valency band and the conduction band is of the order of 10 electron volt. An external electric field cannot provide this amount of energy to an electron in a solid. Therefore, such solids behave as insulators because no free electrons are available to conduct electricity. Semiconductors. The energy band gap between the valency band and the conduction band is small as compared to insulator and more as compared to conductor, as shown in figure. Usually this energy band gap is of the order of 1 electron volt. Germanium and silicon are the best examples, are the common examples of semiconductors. In germanium, the forbidden energy gap is 0.7 electron volt, whereas in case of silicon, it is 1.1 electron volt. Due to the small energy band gap between the valency band and the conduction band, electrons of valency band can be thermally excited to the conduction band, where they are able to conduct small current on the application of electric field to the crystal. At 0 Kelvin temperature, a semiconductor behaves as insulator because the valency band is completely filled with electrons and the conduction band is completely empty. In the valency band, the electrons are tightly bound to the parent nucleus. When the temperature increases, the electrons are excited from valency band to conduction band. But at room temperature, a semiconductor has the following peculiar properties: partially filled conduction band, partially filled valency band, and finally very narrow energy band gap. This is about the semiconductors. While coming to the conductors, here there is no forbidden gap between the valency band and the conduction band. It is observed that the valency band overlaps with the conduction band in metals as shown in figure. There are sufficient number of available free electrical conduction. Since conduction band and valency band overlap in case of metals, so electrons from valency band freely enter into the conduction band. Due to the absence of forbidden band gap between the conduction band and the valency band, there is no chance of the presence of holes. Whereas the holes are present in the semiconductor. In semiconductor, the current due to both electrons and holes, but whereas in conductors, the current due to only the electrons. Hence, the total current in conductors is simply due to the flow of electrons only. In conductors, valency band itself behaves as the conduction band. Due to this reason, metals in general have high electrical conductivity. So, by the above two concepts, the review questions. Describe the basic mechanism of band formation in solids, which is nothing but the origin of energy bands in solids. How does the band theory of solids lead to the classification of solids into conductors, semiconductors and insulators? So that is nothing but the classification of materials into conductors, semiconductors and insulators. Distinguish between metals, semiconductors and insulators on the basis of band structure. So the above question can be asked in because this type also. What are the difference between same the question, that means the question 2, question 3, question 4 has the same answer. Multiple choice questions. The most widely used conducting materials are gold and silver, germanium and silicon, gallium arsenide and its alloy, copper and aluminium. Here germanium and silicon are semiconducting materials, so these are not conducting materials widely. And next, gallium arsenide and its alloy, this is also not widely used because this gallium arsenide is a semiconducting material, so dopant materials. Gold and silver, here the silver and gold are very precious materials, so we can widely use copper and aluminium. Next, in a band structure of solid, width of the allowed energy bands decreases with increase in the binding energy of the electron, decreases in the binding energy of the electron, increases in the kinetic energy of the electron, none of these. Here the answer is increase in the binding energy of electron. Band gap between the conduction band and the valency band of a conductor is, in conductors there is no energy band gap between the conduction band and the valency band. So the answer is D, 0. Order of band gap in an insulator is, in insulator the energy difference between valency band and conduction band is very large, so the energy band gap is in the order of 10 electron volt. Semiconductors have energy band gap of the order of 1 electron volt. Here the energy difference between valency band and conduction band is very small as compared to conductors and insulators. So this is about the origin of energy bands in solids and classification of solids into conductors, semiconductors and insulators. In the next class, we will discuss chemical bonds in semiconductors, that means how the bond formation takes place in semiconductors, and types of semiconductors, that is nothing but intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors, and we can discuss about Fermi energy level. Thank you.